Fist, Forged in Shadow Torch, sure seems like a redundant name, doesn't it? But for a game that requires a fair bit of backtracking, I guess it kind of makes sense. Fist is an absolutely entertaining romp through a diesel punk world inhabited by anamorphic animal characters fighting against oppressive robotic overlords in an effort to save their captured friend. You play as the main protagonist, Rayton, armed with his mechanical fist, fitting, I know, as you traverse the gorgeously crafted 2.5D world. For those uninitiated, 2.5D meaning the game is in a 3D landscape, but operates entirely on a side-scroller format. What makes this one interesting for me, and why I was excited to get the opportunity to dig into it, was the abundance of modern tech packed in. NVIDIA provided me with a code for coverage purposes, so let's explore it together, shall we? Fist may have been published by a Chinese giant Bilibili game, but it was developed by a small studio, TI Games, and they managed to pack a ton of next-gen features in here. You know, at some point, we have to stop calling them next-gen features and just modern features. Either way, TI Games has gone full tilt in partnership with NVIDIA and RTX to treat the eyes with loads of flair. If you want to know more about the entirety of the RTX suite as of now, feel free to hit the card in the upper corner of the screen. Ray tracing is here and in no short supply. Lighting is key to making a world pop, and this one rings true in the world of Fist. Present is ray traced reflections, ray traced global illumination, as well as ray traced caustics and physically based textures. All of these combine to take the lighting in Fist to the next level and give the game visual depth. That does come with a grave cost on performance, however, but NVIDIA's DLSS technology is included with this title to recover those lost frames. Later on, you'll see what makes this DLSS implementation quite interesting and a bit different than what we're used to seeing in the past. Another interesting technology from NVIDIA used in this title is NVIDIA Reflex. This is to reduce system latency, and just like RTX, we have a full explainer of exactly what this technology is linked in the card in the upper corner of the screen. Long and short is, this game can get quite hairy, and you might find the need for lightning quick input responses to get past some of the most intense battles. The implementation of ray tracing in Fist is good, but the options are a bit on the slim side. In fact, I have to take a moment to complain about the way the visual options for advanced features like RT and DLSS are handled. They're not in the game, but only accessible through the main menu of the game. That's an oversight in my opinion, and makes it quite hard to adjust your performance mid-game. In the main menu, there are three options for RT: off, low, and high. That's it. I'm personally not a fan of when individual target options are so limited when a game supports three different kinds of RT functions. Here's a breakdown of which option handles which feature. RT low enables reflections and caustics, while RT high enables reflections and caustics along with global illumination. So, how do they look? Well, they look great, but I know what you're thinking. Since this is a side-scrolling game with a limited camera viewport, it doesn't need things like RT reflections to make up off-screen objects. Well, in an opening area of the game here, we can look to see how RT reflections really make reflective surfaces pop. Look at the tiles in the foreground, and notice how they have texture and not just a sheen like the ray tracing off. And the reflection of the sign is clear with RT low enabled instead of a low resolution screen space effect. Even more, the vertical pipes on the left has reflections from various angles, and later you're going to see the performance impact is quite interesting on this one. Now crank the options to high and you'll see the inclusion of global illumination, which adds the depth of color around all of the light sources and gives the world a natural glow. With all of this in mind, let's check out another area of the game. Here you can see the impact a bit more, especially on the caustics and reflection, where you can notice how the door on the right of the screen has so much more depth when RT is enabled. For the most part, you can get by with RT on low most of the time and have a great experience. But there are some parts of the game when the environment gets brighter and the global illumination really makes your character and others on screen really pop in a way that baked lighting just can't do. As always, ray tracing brings a performance impact, and this game is no different. But before we have a look at those numbers, we have to discuss the implementation of DLSS in this title, which is one of the most interesting uses I've seen to date. In the main menu, there's no option for quality levels, only auto, with the ability to adjust sharpening. It's quite limiting, but how does it look? Well, quite good in my opinion. And a big reason for this is that Fist uses a per object motion blur that actually aids in the cleaning up of potential artifacts commonly introduced by DLSS. In fact, I really don't know why you wouldn't just enable it by default, as it sharpens up the image a little bit compared to the native TAA used by the Unreal Engine 4 and makes the image a bit crisper. From there, you can feel free to adjust the sharpening level to your liking, and I've found no performance impact from doing so. Speaking of performance, this title does have a frame rate cap of 120 FPS, and that means the theoretical top-end performance could be much higher than what we're able to measure. Tested at 4K running a Ryzen 9 3900X and a Founders Edition RTX 3080 with ray tracing disabled, Fist runs on a comfortable 115 FPS on average. Enable RT on low and we see a literal 5 FPS performance hit as it drops to 110 FPS. But if you want to crank things out with RT high, prepare to see your frame rates drop over half to around 50 FPS mark in my testing area. But don't count it out just yet because you still have DLSS as an option. Enabling DLSS with RT off locks the FPS at that 120 FPS limit, and the same goes for RT on low. With DLSS, RT High sees more than double the frame rates it got without. So, full RT High is back on the table, boys. Fist is a game that I saw float about some time ago, and since my time with it, I've found it to be a truly enjoyable experience so far. I very much look forward to finishing this game and appreciate seeing how well such a small studio has put together these modern DX12 features. What we have here is a beautiful game that gives you advanced options to really sink your newer hardware into. It also manages to give you some great ray tracing features, even if you don't own a DLSS capable GPU to push it to the max. While the frame rate cap really puts a damper on the ability to see the true impact of ray tracing in this title, I don't think 120 FPS is going to feel like much of a limit here. Now, I want to thank you all for joining me today in this adventure into the world of Fist and its graphical features. If you enjoyed it, let me know by hitting the thumbs up and make sure you're subscribed here at PC World for future featured analysis.